Okay, another little glitchy bit. By the time I've edited this, it should look quite a mess, but you'll get the gist of it all. So I've left the camera facing the more interesting bits and pieces rather than me. There's no need for you to look at me. You've seen me too many times before, probably. So I'm just gonna give a bit of interest. I don't know what the time is. I'm just getting on. It must be getting on for 5-ish, I should think, judging by the amount of traffic there's about. Anyway, this is Bramblebush Bay, the name of this ferry. It's quite a few years old. It replaced an even older one, which was like a humpback design thing. It was really weird. But they replaced it with this, which has been fairly reliable in its operation, as far as I'm aware. They've not really had any major problems with it. So, it's been an old faithful up to this point. Just plodding away across the water there to the other side, backwards and forwards, that's all it ever does. It's not self-propelled other than by the chains. I mean, it's got engines in it, obviously, but they are purely for turning capstans, which pulls a chain through, and that's what powers the thing. But as for self-propelled, no. If it was to break free, it would be at the mercy of the current. It would just go. In fact, that did happen to the older one, apparently, some time ago. I think I remember some article in the local rag about it when it actually broke free. The chains were being stressed beyond their capability. They were old chains and probably a little bit corroded, so they gave up the ghost and away it went. But it was recaptured with no problems to anybody. Must have been quite a scary experience, though. Depending on which way it went. If it went out to the channel, yes, that would have been a little bit problematical, because there's some pretty hefty rocks out that way. Not so much going the other way. Going right of this picture. If you were to go right, you would go into the Poole Harbour itself. Yeah, you're not going to come to too much harm in there. Apart from big ships bearing down on you, but apart from that, nah, you'd be okay. Out the other way, yeah, you'd have a way to go to get out into the actual open water, but you'd be on the wrong side of the land anyway. So, and this is my latest little offering, number 26, I believe this is. Pretty sure it is. Can you see the swell on the bottom of that thing? It actually does lift it. It's amazing. I mean, it's not the heaviest thing afloat by any stretch of the imagination, but to think that that can float at all is pretty amazing. See, water is a fairly amazing thing, isn't it? It has no power to conform to the shape of an exterior object, or let me rephrase that. It has no power to be able to conform to the shape of an underwater object, such as a mountain. The geography on the bottom of the sea is pretty much the same as it is anywhere else. But the water doesn't conform to the shapes underneath it. It just doesn't. It lies flat. Okay, you can see ripples and little wavelets. Okay, and sometimes you can see big wavelets. And even huger ones out in the open ocean. But essentially, water lies flat. It can't do anything else. It has no power to do other than what it does. It has to lie the way it does, which is flat from edge to edge. And you say, well, if we lived on a flat earth, surely the water would fall off the sides. Well, that's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. The reason the water doesn't flow off the sides is because the earth as we live on it is surrounded by Antarctica. Antarctica is not a continent, it's an ice wall which surrounds the whole of the earth we live on. You don't think the Almighty is so stupid he would just not put a barrier between the water and the land, do you? I mean, how ridiculous can you be? That is why the water doesn't drop off the sides anyway. There's no sides for it to drop off. There's no space, so It's not going to drop off into space because there is no space. This reality is all we know about. We don't know anything other than the reality and the physics we enjoy here on this physical living Earth. That's all there is. We don't know anything else, and we won't know anything else until that day comes when we are reunited with our Almighty Father. And then everything in his own good time will be revealed to us. But right now, we are contained, like in a terrarium. We have a dome above us, which is called the firmament, which is where our sky, our clouds, everything is underneath that firmament. Above it sits the Almighty. So you might think, well, the sky is blue, it reflects it. No, the sky is blue because the water above. Read the Bible. The Bible tells you quite specifically and quite categorically that the waters above and below the earth. Well, people also say, well, what drives tides? What makes tides? Nobody really knows, but I have a theory that the tides may actually be caused by the fountains of the deep. Water may... See, the earth is alive. It's not a dead rock. It's essentially alive, and you think that is impossible? Don't underestimate our Creator. The earth is alive, so it possibly respirates. It's possibly built and created to respirate, so the water goes in and it goes out, thereby creating the tides. Not too hard a concept to grasp, is it? For a lot it will be, but for most people, no, it's not a very hard concept. That's people with more than one working brain cell, of course. But these people just will not get their heads around the fact there's a living Creator. There couldn't be anything at all were it not for him. So every time people bring up this flat earth, I won't say we live on a flat earth, but to all intents and purposes it is. I'm not a flat earther. I do not like labels of any description. I know that the earth has never been seen in its entirety by anybody. That's just a fact. It's never been seen in its entirety. So nobody knows exactly what the shape of the earth is. But what we do know is it is not a physics and incredulous spinning ball. That it is not. It cannot be. Our physics do not allow for such an idiotic concept. And the physics we have wouldn't allow that even to be in existence. It couldn't exist because the physics wouldn't allow it to exist. There's such a thing as centrifugal force. The centrifugal force alone, at the speeds we are told that this supposed globe Earth revolves at, This centrifugal force alone would rip it apart before it was even formed. Centrifugal force is a real force. Gravity is a load of bullshit. Gravity is just a word, just a concept that's dreamt up to cover all their bullshit because it can't be disproven. It can't be disproven because it's just a ludicrous concept. What gravity actually is probably mass, density, and buoyancy, which you can see an example of that buoyancy by that ferry that's just floating across there. That's buoyancy. It has the mass, it has the density, and it also has the buoyancy because the water buoys it up. That is our physics. Were there such a thing as this gravity, it wouldn't be selective on what it sticks down to the face of this ball. It would suck everything down as far as it could possibly do it towards the center of this spinning ball, supposedly. So everything would be sucked down. Everything would be sucked to the... Everything that went on the water would be sucked down through the water to the substrate below. And God knows what would happen to things on land. They'd be squashed flat. Nothing could exist. It's a ridiculous concept, and I wish people would drop it, grow a brain, and start realizing they do not live on a spinning ball, never have lived on a spinning ball, and never could live on a spinning ball. It's utterly ludicrous. People need to believe their five senses. Their five senses will tell them that we do not move. We have no movement. the movement of the clouds in the sky, which go varying directions in different layers. Now, how does that work if, so say, they say the atmosphere is staple to the Earth. So as the Earth revolves, the atmosphere goes with it. Well, that isn't patently isn't true, because if it were, everything would go in the same direction as a rotation, not against it. So that's utter bullshit for a kickoff. The fact that you could gain altitude no matter how high you go in an aircraft or whatever other thing you want to go up in, that the horizon will always come to eye level. It always will, no matter how high up you be. Now, real physics, if you look upon if you get a football or a beach ball, hold it up to your face, all right, and pretend that is where you live. You live on this ball. Now, because of the scale is different, the physics would remain the same. It's just a scaled down version. That's all it is. So as you move your face away from the surface of that ball, what happens? The ball disappears beneath you as you're looking at it. It drops away from you. The higher you go, the more it'll drop away until you don't see anything of the ball at all. Try that on an aircraft and see whether the horizon drops away from you. It won't, because it can't, because we don't live on a ball. Is that clear enough? Is that succinct enough for you people that really believe we live on this stupid globe? I really hope you grasp it, because time isn't on our side. The importance of where we live is not about the shape of it as so much as the reasons for the globe existing in the first place. The globe exists to obfuscate a creator. I'm going to call it a flat earth because it's the only way I can describe it as I see it at the moment. If it's a flat earth, which it patently is, or a flat-ish earth, then it must have been created. It can't have come from a big bang. It can't have come from gases spinning around a load of bollocks nebulas, which also don't exist, incidentally. So the fact that the Earth is supposedly a globe perfectly obfuscates the creator, which is what this is all about. It's not about the shape of the damn Earth. It's about the most important bit of whether it was created, which it obviously was. No creator, anything goes. Idiocy goes, and it does. They talk about light years and stupid nonsense like that, which have got no meaning. There's no such thing as a light year. It's utterly ridiculous and ludicrous, but they have you believe there is. All they do is pick a number, add as many noughts on it as they feel like they can write, and that doubles for truth. Well, not in my books, it doesn't. There's no such thing as light years. There's no such thing as millions of miles either. We don't live millions of miles from anywhere. Our Earth is a limited, controlled, and dare I say, an enclosed reality. That's what it is. If you don't like the fact that you live on a created earth and there is a dome or a firmament, I don't particularly like the word dome, firmament, there is a firmament above us which separates us from the Almighty. We couldn't exist were that firmament not there. This is where we live our physical lives. Spiritual lives, we couldn't exist as flesh and blood in a spiritual world. We couldn't. This is the world we were given, for whatever reason the Almighty's got to give us this world, and this is where we live our physical lives, and this is our, I believe, our proving ground. This is where the sheep are metaphorically separated from the goats. Metaphorically, sheep and goats, I add, because the Almighty doesn't make any creatures that are less than others. Sheep and goats are both nice animals. Sheep are quite silly in some respects, but as I say, as a metaphor, sheep and goats works. there are some very strange things happening this year, this 2020, this COVID nonsense is ongoing. And the number of fools I see around with masks on, even now. Most of the places are open. This car park was closed some while back because of this COVID nonsense. As I said, the chain ferry itself wasn't running because of the COVID. And also it had maintenance issues as well. They had to sort the maintenance schedule out. So what better time to do it in the lockdown nonsense? But it's ridiculous, it really is. There's about as much truth in this COVID as there is in NASA landing men on the moon. Zero. Absolute zero. No. This is our reality. This is the world we live on. Wherever we happen to be, this is my tiny little portion of the world I live in. I live on. I can travel from where I live to here because I know the area and I know roughly the time it takes to get here. And everything revolves around everybody's lives to where they're locally. There's another one with a mask on. Oh, dear God. It makes me so angry. It's just a local concept to us because most of us don't travel where maybe we'd like to travel due to whatever constraints, be it financial in most cases, political, you name it. But the part of the world I know and I like this part of the world very much because of that wide open, beautiful countryside over there. You can keep your towns and cities. What I like is open air to be able to breathe, which is a bit of a sore point in this day and age. Day and age. Oh, God. Another stupid meme. But you know where I'm coming from on this. That people want to muzzle themselves voluntarily is just a bridge too far for me. Yes, it's a very, very odd, peculiar time we find ourselves in, but it's here for a reason. It's here because I believe things have gotten to such a level on the Almighty's timeline for us, not his timeline, because he doesn't have anything to do with time. Time exists for us, so his timeline for us here is moving towards some sort of apotheosis, I believe. There's a nice word for you, apotheosis. I like that word. And it is coming. I mean, anybody with a bit of intuition can probably sense that things aren't as they should be. But they certainly aren't at the moment, are they? And the fact that things have altered and people's lives have been turned upside down so quickly, and for absolutely no reason at all, that tells me there's something major in the air. And like I keep saying, this shit will not go away. It will not. I can't see it ever going away. Because if they do, it's like the space nonsense and the moon nonsense and all the rest of the so-called space bullshit they give us. They can't go back on it because if they do, they're finished. These satanic pieces of crap that dream all this shit up, they're finished. So they've got to run with it and make it more and more ludicrous. And the more and more ludicrous they make it, the more people seem to believe it. Take this COVID as a prime example. I mean, what are people doing walking around with fucking face masks on them? Excuse the F, bomb. But what is the matter with these people? They have got to be mentally impaired in some way. I find it scary. It scares me, not the so-called disease or whatever they want to call it, because that doesn't exist. There's nothing to fear from nothing. What I do fear is people, the way people react, like they've completely changed. They become less than what they were. They become less than, almost less than human. In a lot of cases, their incredulity, their disbelief, anything could be real outside of what they're told, their quickness to assault people verbally, and well, I think it's going to happen on a physical level at some point, because this, all this is doing is building more and more stress in these people, and they're going to snap. They're going to start doing really crazy things, crazier than the things they do now, like fighting, even to the point of killing people. This is where I think this is going. This is Satan's plan. This is what it wants to happen. It wants complete anarchy. It wants complete dissolution of anything that keeps the veneer of civilization together. It hates us with a vengeance. This is what you need to understand. It exists, it hates us, and it hates the Almighty's creation with a vengeance. So anything it can do, especially to humanity, which it hates most of all, because humanity has found favor in the Almighty's, as Almighty's creation, above the satanic beast itself, even when it wasn't, humanity had a special place and holds a special place. So all these people that try to put humanity down, saying, oh, we come from germs and algae, and we come from monkeys, and we've evolved from rocks and all sorts of other weirdy stuff. Oh, what a load of crap. I mean, give it a rest. The idiocy knows no ends, does it? It really doesn't. But what can you do? What can you do? Not a lot. Yeah, it's a most peculiar, and as I said, a scary scenario. I don't know where this is going to end. I don't know how it's going to mature into something pretty horrific, but I'm damn sure it will. This will not be the final phase. There is more to come. As I say, keep watching this space, folks. It's not going to be a nice thing. It's really not going to be a nice place to live. At the moment, yeah, people can sort of get on with their lives to a degree, and apart from the bullshit nonsense with these masks and everything. But wait till the vaccines start to appear, and they're, believe me, they're in production somewhere or other. And speaking of vaccines, now this is something I can't really get to grips with. I'm not a biologist. I haven't got any letters after my name, except for, well, I won't go into that. You can make your own guess as to what letters they put after my name, but not that that means anything. But people that have works in the field that know about microbiology and know about vaccines and know about how these companies work that produce them, they have some very good examples of people that will tell you exactly what is going on, because not everybody is subject to Satan's ploys. The Almighty has certainly made certain that he can use whoever he wants for his own ends, and to that end, there are people who definitely are fighting for us by grace of the Almighty, by grace of the Messiah. These people know what is going on, and they have spoken, and they have put their real tested knowledge on the line and explained exactly what is going on regarding the vaccines. Okay, now I'm going to give you a verbal link. Now please pay attention. This is an important one. The name I want you to tap into your YouTube search is Patch, P-A-T-C-H, Anthony Patch, okay? I'll spell it all out in phonetics, so there is no excuse for anybody not being able to find it. Alpha November, H Hotel, oh sorry, A-N-T-H-O-N-Y, Anthony. Okay, I didn't do it in phonetics. Alpha November Hotel Tango, Oscar, November, Yankee, Anthony. I think I got that right. Patch, Papa, Alpha, Charlie. Papa, Alpha, Tango, Charlie, Hotel, Patch. I wish I hadn't started doing that in phonetics now. I do know them, but it's kind of thinking of it. All right, you got it anyway. Anthony Patch on YouTube. He's an older gentleman, probably younger than I am, but not by much, I wouldn't think. But who cares? Him and his wife, who is called Kathleen. That reminds me of that Irish thing. I'll take you home again, Kathleen. No, not, I'm not taking the mickey. That's her name, Kathleen. It's quite a nice name anyway. Look them up on YouTube. They make long videos, but they're fascinating videos, and the guy isn't talking out the back of his head. He actually does know what he's talking about regarding these vaccines. You would be well advised, if you haven't already seen him, to find the channel. I did, by complete accident, apparently by accident. But I came across his channel and I thought, ah, this looks interesting. And by God, it is interesting. So do take a look, because you will learn something from him. The other channels, obviously, I'll mention them again, are Globebusters. Globebusters across the universe. Well, the non-universe. Also on YouTube, that's Globebusters. There is DITRH, Deep Inside the Rabbit Hole, if I got that right. Deep Inside the Rabbit Hole, but just use the initials of each word. Another great channel. Well worth visiting. There's so many decent channels. Rose777, that's R-O-S-E, Rose777. These are all American people I'm giving you, incidentally. So for you American subscribers, you probably already know these people. English ones, there are some English people. I don't actually follow English or British YouTube so-called flat earthers, because I find the American are quite a bit ahead of the game. And I'm not putting the British people down either. There are some very good ones, but you can't subscribe to everybody. I just like the American style. Who have we got here? I'm trying to think, actually. I actually will subscribe to a couple of them. I forget to. That's the bottom line. I do forget. Golly. I cannot think of these channels. What I will do, if I don't remember them in the next few seconds, I will actually try and remember to look them up on YouTube and actually tap the names in. I won't do it on audio. I'll put some lettering up on the screen. That should be a bit better. In fact, while I think of it, I'll do a list of all the channels, including the ones I've mentioned. I'll put them actually on the screen so you can view them, and then you can subscribe. I would, you know, subscribe by all means. They're well worth subscribing to. Oh, and I still can't think of these English guys' channel. Ranty is one of them. R-A-N-T-Y, Ranty. Not Ranty Rat, I don't think. It's Ranty. It could be, I don't know. I can't even remember his bloody YouTube name now. But it's Ranty anyway. Spelt the way I've just said. Excuse the yawn. I cannot think of any more offhand. I was listening to somebody talking about him this morning on YouTube. Mind you, I've been gone for a few hours, so it's kind of slipped my mind. But yeah, I'll make a list of them. Okay, well, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to shut this one down. I don't know how long I've been on here. Probably about half an hour, maybe. But with a bit of video in between, I'll add it to this one to make it kind of a little bit more interesting than they hitherto have been, with just me prattling away in front of a camera at home, which is, I must admit, not the best way of doing things. I'm trying to make it as interesting as possible, while giving as much information as possible, and getting those who aren't on board, as best I can. And the only way I can do it is the way I am doing it, as far as I can see. If there's any more revelations coming my way, then the Almighty will give them. But right now, I can't think of a better way of getting what I need to get across than doing it like this. So I will shut it down here for now, and catch you all later. Maybe even after I've edited this, I'll put this up as it is. But I hope you have been able to glean something from this, on this 26th diatribe of mine. Thank you for watching, and have a great day wherever you are in the world, on the world. And I will no doubt speak to you next week, Almighty willing, of course. Okay, folks, thank you, and a very good day to you from me, Collie Candle, here at the Chain Ferry at Sandbanks in Dorset County, England.